안녕하세요 여러분, EBS 생활영어의 선현우입니다. 반갑습니다.
안녕하세요 여러분, and welcome back to another episode of EBS 생활영어. I'm Megan Bowen.
안녕하세요. 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
Good to see you. So usually our topics, the topics for our episodes mm-hmm. are like independent from each other.
Right. But this time, I think it's opposite of the last show, right?
맞아요. Mm-hmm. 보통 이제 저희가 주제들을 이번 시즌에 정하면서 다 서로 약간 독립된 주제들을 고르고 있어요. 특별히 서로 주제들 간의 관련은 없는데 mm-hmm. 오늘은 어제 이야기했던 주제와 좀 관련이 있습니다. 반대로 바꿔봤는데요. 오늘의 질문 소개하겠습니다.
Okay, so today's question is what's something you'd never want to try?
Okay, what's something you would never want to try? Mm-hmm. 살면서 절대 시도해 볼 것 같지 않은 일이 있다면 무엇인지 한 분에게 질문을 해봤습니다. Mm-hmm. 누구죠?
So today we have Janelle who's from America.
네, 자넬 씨에게 이야기를 해봤는데 mm-hmm. 재미있는 거는 mm-hmm. 요약 문장을 보시면은 굉장히 놀라실 수도 있어요. 지난 시간에 리처드 씨에게 질문했던 거랑 반대되는 거잖아요.
Yeah.
두 분이 서로 이야기하지 않았거든요. 의논하지 않았거든요.
Oh, really?
관련이 있습니다. 오늘의 대답도.
Okay, well, how about we move right into it and see what she says in her speaking summary.
Okay.
Skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it. Skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it. Skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it.
신기하게도 저넬 씨도 스카이다이빙 이야기를 해주고 있어요. 물론 내용은 반대지만요. 자세히 같이 볼까요?
So she says, skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it.
네. 리차드 씨는 스카이다이빙을 해보고 싶다고 했고, 저넬 씨는 절대 못할 것 같다는 이야기를 하네요. 사람마다 다르겠죠. Skydiving looks really fun. 스카이다이빙은 정말 재미있어 보이지만 mm-hmm. but there's just so many factors involved. 여기서 말하는 factor라는 거는 변수를 말하고 있어요. Mm-hmm. 그래서 변수가 워낙 많이 작용을 하기 때문에 뭐 날씨 또는 그날의 컨디션 다양하겠죠. And I don't think I could, 또는 I don't think that I could ever try it. Mm-hmm. 절대 시도해 볼 수 있을 것 같지가 않아요.
Wow. Okay. Well, everyone has their own opinion.
Exactly.
And since we've gone over it, let's look at her speaking summary once again.
Skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it. Skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it. Skydiving looks really fun, but there's just so many factors involved, and I don't think that I could ever try it.
자, 요약 문장을 다시 한번 확인해 본 건데요.
Yes, so we took a look at her speaking summary once again. Now it's time for us to move on to the section where we're going to look at the entire clip that she sent us. It's time for English on the go. It's the time of the show where we're going to take a look at a clip sent to us from a native speaker who could be anywhere in the world, of course, you know. Today we have Janelle from the USA, and she's going to talk to us about why she would never try skydiving. She talks a bit about skydiving, jumping out of a plane thousands of feet in the air. Let's take a look at her clip.
Just wanna ignite ya!
Are you ready? Go!
I consider myself a pretty outgoing person, but one thing I don't think I could ever do is skydiving. It's very unlikely that anything bad would happen because you're probably more likely to get in a car accident or something like that. But just the thought of even jumping with a professional, you're jumping out of a plane, thousands of feet in the air, and anything could go wrong. And everything in my brain just tells me, why would you want to do it? Don't ever do that. Ugh, as exciting as it looks, I don't think I could skydive.
자, 그럼 이 영상을 가지고 공부를 본격적으로 해볼 텐데요. 그 전에 단어 몇 가지 주요 단어 확인하겠습니다. 첫 번째, outgoing. Go out 하면은 밖으로 나가는 거잖아요. 근데 outgoing이라고 이렇게 뒤집어서 말하면 이제 혼자 여기에만 뭔가 유지하고 있지 않고 내가 먼저 다가가는 느낌 또는 밖으로 좀 많이 열심히 돌아다니고 적극적인 느낌을 포함한 외향적인이란 뜻을 가지게 됩니다. Outgoing, 성격 이야기죠. 그 다음, unlikely. Likely의 반대말이에요. Unlikely 하면 확률이 낮은, 그럴 일이 생길 것 같지 않은. 반대말로 이제 likely, 앞에 un, un 부분을 떼버리게 되면 확률이 높은, 그런 일이 생길 법한. Probably 하면 아마도라는 말인데요. Maybe보다는 probably가 더 probability, 확률이 높습니다. 발음 연습해볼까요?
Let's practice our pronunciation. These are probably going to be a little bit easier for you. So let's go over them. The first one, outgoing. 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 The next one, unlikely. 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 The last one, probably. 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 Let's go on to the next three.
네, 다음으로 이제 본문에 나온 순서대로 저희가 소개를 하다 보니까 아까 unlikely랑 지금 따로 떨어져서 나오게 됐는데 likely입니다. 확률이 높은, 그런 일이 꽤 있을 법한이라고 할 때 likely. 그 다음으로 professional. professional 하면은 형용사로는 전문적인, 프로다운 이런 말이고요. 전문가, with a professional이라는 말이 이제 본문에 나오는데 전문가와 함께, 그래서 a 앞에 뭐가 붙었다 그러면은 전문가라는 사람, expert와 비슷한 걸로 생각하시면 되겠습니다. 그 다음, go wrong. 무언가가 잘못 가다라는 말은 잘못되다. 우리말로는 그렇게 이야기를 하죠. go wrong, 잘못되다. 자, 발음 연습해볼까요?
Alright, let's take a look at the last three. The first one is likely. 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 Professional. Professional, professional. Go wrong, go wrong, go wrong. So, since we have gone over the vocabulary words, let's take a look at the clip once again. But this time, Janelle's clip will have English subtitles.